Firstly, I would say that the market is going to continue to grow in the UAE over a multitude of different areas. So if you look at the United Arab Emirates in terms of a global market for banks to succeed in, I think it's very good. It's one of the most attractive markets, certainly in the region, and probably across the West-East corridor, to be frank. I think in all of our major three businesses, both our wealth management, where I see enormous opportunity as people want to buy more insurance products, they want to buy more investment products, they want to buy more bond products, they want to look at real estate in a different way to what they have in the past. All of that will develop as asset classes develop, as customers demand more types of investment asset classes. So I'm very positive about that area. The second area is that I also think within the retail space, there's a lot of opportunity in terms of providing services much, much more effectively and efficiently through the utilization of smartphones and iPads. And within that, I think a lot more what I would call basic products will be sold through those mediums going forward. So you won't have call centers so much as I think, call centers have been a very important part together with branches in selling products. But I think what will be the big delta will be selling of products through the net and through the various areas. So things like mortgage applications, personal loans, all of this will become more and more end-to-end delivered by the net. And I think that's a marvelous opportunity. Lastly, if I move to the wholesale bank, I think what is going to really develop over the next 3 or 4 years is more product requirements around flow products such as foreign exchange, options, more bonds and capital markets development will come about. So again, the traditional side of corporate banking, which has been lending led, will still be there, but it will change more to the capital markets. You'll see more sophistication in the way that we deliver trade services. You'll see more sophistication as we deliver cash management. And I think that's already started in a very aggressive way in the UAE, the latter two. But I think there are going to be enormous opportunities in these areas in the UAE. So I see that the UAE from two ways. Margin compression in one way, but new opportunities in another way. And that will challenge us all to change our banks. I think the state of liquidity in the UAE banking system is good. And I think the central bank has done a great job, together with all of the banking industry, in managing their balance sheet. I think everyone around the world, with the possible exception of a lot of the Asian banks who were traditionally very strong in liquidity, learned from 2008 and realized that strength of liquidity, strength of balance sheet, is what keeps you in the game for a long, long time for your customers. And if you can't meet your customer requirements when there is a tightness of liquidity globally or within a country, then you have a position that your customers may go sell elsewhere. So I think the state of liquidity of the banking sector here is good. Is it outstanding? Not yet, but this is part of our development. And we at NBAD are very clear that the foundation that we must live off is the strength of liquidity, not only from our government and corporate business, which has been our traditional, but increasingly from our retail business. And we're seeing good growth in the 4 to 5% per quarter range in our deposit base from our retail customers. So this, I think, holds us in good stead that we will be in a very strong liquidity position for a number of years. And that, to me, is the key of banking. Let me try and break up in summary, what I think will happen to the industry here in the UAE. I think there will be a continuation of banks who will be domestic-led and domestic-based, and that's good. Those banks, though, will change their models. And I think particularly in the retail space, you will start to see new changes in their business models, which I think have already started to come about. And I think if margin compression continues, it will just accelerate the pace of that. And then I think there will be 2 or 3 banks that will start to emerge from the UAE, and of which NBAD will be the lead, to create a more broader proposition. They will still be powerful within their local market. And in our case, we want to get stronger in the local market, particularly in the retail and commercial space. But they will also spread their wings around the strategic relevance of the UAE as part of what I would call this West-East corridor. And that they will start to move into those areas. And it's interesting to see that already the Singapore government has started to see the virtue of the Gulf, and specifically the UAE, in trying to build commercial connectivity that will allow easier movement of trade and investment. So not every bank in the UAE will take that strategy. And it requires you to be different, not better, not worse, but different in order to be successful. We will be one of those banks. And that's part of the transformation that we're going through. And it is a big transformation. It requires different culture. It requires different approaches to risk. It requires different approaches to how you deliver technology. And I think the benefit, if we're successful, is it will make the local banking proposition for us stronger, but it will also help the industry. But I'm sure we won't be on a standalone basis. And I do see in 2 or 3 years' time, other banks doing the same, if they're not already.